Tes cek. Okay. So this is the next session. Today I will bring our discussion about EBPF. Previously, sorry. This is the first time I talk in the public, especially in the Asia level. So I will be little gorgeous. So please take. Ya itulah, sorry. So actually for this season I will use bahasa, but I changed my mind, so I will use English. Okay, let's start. First, let me introduce myself. My name is Aldin Siawan. My main job is simping, dukun engineer, and the last was I was team cloud engineer at BTech. You can contact me at GitHub, LinkedIn, email, Discord, and blog. This is a disclaimer of my topic. So this is an open discussion. If you not agree with my statement or anything else, you can direct to ask me, or yeah, we can have discussion. And second is, I will not compare the vendor. I mean, I will not compare the tools A, tools B, or provider A, provider B, because in here I will talk about the technology itself. And the last was, we are not installing some tools. After that, we can do benchmark and make a conclusion. Okay, first thing is, let's talk about the BPF, the ancestor one. The name is BPF. The technology was actually pretty old. It was 1992, even I was not yet born, and already existed a long time ago. Its originally was developed in Berkeley University. And the original purpose is for the filtering packet, in example, TCP dump. So here's the rule, the simple rule. At the time, 1992, we don't have 100 core or CPU. So the way to solve your problem is easy. Optimize your software. Problem at the time was inefficient packet filtering, low resource, and complex debugging network. This was the packet filter at the time. The design was the network packets was delivered to the kernel space. After that, sent it to user space. As you can see, there's no filtering in the kernel level. So that makes the filtering process should be in the user space, not in the kernel space. And another thing is, we need to bring we need forward the package from kernel level to the user space to filtering. So that was the optimized one, because we sold forward the packets from kernel to user space. After that, we sold filtering the packet in the user space itself. Now, eBPF has come to the solution. How eBPF work? BPF work, they are filtered the unwanted packets to interpret context in the kernel itself. As you can see, the network packets, after reach the kernel space, they will copy into the BPF, or it's called like TAPS interface. After that, filtering in the kernel itself. So there's no forwarding into user space or filtering on user space itself. This optimization was pretty big revolutionary at that time, because it's from the benchmark itself. It's almost 30% faster than filtering packets at that time. Here's the illustration. If you work in IT infrastructure, especially in networking or DevOps, you should know the IP TCP dump, right? Here's the illustration. Previously, the packet filter was without eBPF will filter it in the user space. here were the his words the illustration. You can grab in the user space. And that make the CPU and memory or other resource will be take higher because yes, we filtering packets at user space itself. But with BPF, we filtering packet on the place, on the kernel itself. Now come the problem. Yeah, we already solved the problem, but we still have the problem, many problem in this world. So if you already experience with the kernel stuff, like adding the module or upgrading or removing or maybe creating the module itself, you should know if the kernel level was hard to change. It's not easy like in the user space when you want to change Nginx application listening port, you can edit blah blah and start and restart. After that, you get error and troubleshooting and change again and starting again and running well. But in kernel space, you cannot do that. That's the rule in the kernel space because kernel space was very, very restrict. If you make a mistake in kernel space, yes, you can doom your system. You cannot boot up or even more, you should reboot your kernel or install the OS from the scratch again. So now we know if the kernel space was hard to change, but how the BPF come to make dynamically filtering package in itself. So take create a clever solution for that at that time. Take create for me is unbelievable strategy. Take create a virtual machine bytecode inside the kernel itself. You can image it like the Java virtual machine bytecode inside the kernel. So of course, since that virtual machine in the kernel space, they create their CPU infrastructure itself. So as you can see in the diagram, if we want create the BPF or yeah filtering packets, first the CPU dump will call the libcap, then compile the program. After that, BPF code was created. When the BPF created, it's not we cannot running immediately, but we should verify the eBPF code was not broke your system. So there will be challenging in eBPF verification. After verification complete, eBPF will harden your BPF program into the kernel itself. Now come to the nowadays. This is the future. We already have 100 or million core or giga and blah blah. But so where's the problem? Why we still use BPF or why we still worry about packet filtering? Meanwhile, we already have the good resource. We have the supercomputer with amazing spec and amazing network specification. Yes. The server nowadays was have powerful resource like 100 or million or I don't know gazillion terabyte or that thing, but today all device was required network, even your toaster, even your smartwatch. Nowadays was everything was connected to internet, and that makes the require make double or triple. And that makes the load too high too. And another option is networking today, not only to connecting one bare metal or one compute to another compute. Networking today was can happening inside the compute itself. In example, yes, the service mesh or pod communication pod and service like Docker or Kubernetes, they are still inside the compute, but there's networking happen in there. IP tables. Yeah, this is our tools. You can see IP tables was pretty old. It's actually, it's already, the code was written 20 years ago. So many problem was happening today. Just like an example, in Kalenium reference, over the years, IP tables has blessing and curse. A blessing is flexibility for fix, for quick fix. A curse during time debugging 5K rules IP tables. So IP tables was not designed to have 1,000 or million IP rules in the one compute. That's the problem. That's make our bottleneck. And another option is, sorry, another opinion is IP tables using chain to work. So what costing one chain to another chain? Yes, it's CPU time. Just like I said. Because IP tables using chain, so when packet move from chain to one to chain two, chain one to chain three and forward. What they cost? Yes, CPU. Not only CPU, but only memory. You can check it in the kernel stuff. Okay, I will demo how to Atlas how eBPF work in today. Sorry, today. You all can see it, right? It's clear? Yeah, I think it's clear. So, sorry. So in here, I have the script, the eBPF script. It was have role to filtering the UDP packet, and after that, if the UDP packet was the UDP packet have port destination 2525, it will be dropped. So as you can see, the eBPF packet was already injected with the UDP ID 115. Now let's try to check if the UDP packet was forwarded or not. I will use NC for this one. So as you can see, the destination who was injected the eBPF code was not receive any package in the host itself. Why? Because eBPF was already blocking. But how we verify if eBPF was working? So in eBPF, actually you can trace what any program you write on and print the output like this one. What? Sorry, a little misconfig. I think I have some problem, so I will back. Good thing I already recorded it. So sorry. So this one, I already listen UDP port at 2025. After that, I will use TCP dump to trace if there's packet dropping in the interface itself. But the output was known. The TCP dump was not dumping any package incoming. Why is can be happen? But instead, when I trying to trace with my output, it will outputting. Yes. This make it. This is the verify. When I am echoing the test to the host, who injected the eBPF, the host injected eBPF TCP dump was not not show it. It's because the first time packet was handled by XDP, not the TCP dump. Let's continue. So how can it happen? The packet was received by host, even the TCP dump can see it. The magic behind SDP, or the magic behind eBPF was the one is called XDP, or extra data path. As you, when we see the introduction or the manual page, the XDP provide bare metal package processing at the lowest point of the software stack. Or SKB. SKB, TLDR, the SKB was socket buffer. It was the fundamental of package networking. It was happening before the socket created in the Linux kernel. So how the XDP doing this? How they can filtering package in the interface itself? Even the TCP dump was cannot showing up. So XDP has three mode. First is native mode, and second is generative mode. The native mode, XDP will call the driver of Linux interface to tell if the package was salt handled by XDP first. After that, they will forward to into Linux space. And the second thing is, we have the generative mode. It's actually the same like the TC of our traffic control structure data, but it was generative. Actually, that one was for the virtual interface, like the first peer or dummy interface. So I'm not discussing about the generative one, but native one. And the latest version or the latest news is XDP was supporting the Smart NIC. If you are working on data center or big networking project, smart NIC is have called DPU or data gram processor unit or like that. So eBPF will loaded and running in the Smart NIC itself. So it will not use the host CPU and memory. That make the networking process will be go faster and more efficiently because the host was not handling the CPU the networking stuff, but the NIC itself will handling the filtering and networking stuff. This is was the research from the Cloudflare. They have researched how to drop 10 million packets in second. As you can see, the XDP was one and have grabbed a gap. Have a big gap between another tools like application or BPF, IP tables and IP tables in input chain, pre-route and NFT tables ingress. How can XDP won with this crazy gap? Because SDP was use simple rule. The packet should filtered in the place, not forwarding into another space. So this is was eBPF capability. eBPF can do networking security and observability. Yeah, we are talking about the networking stuff. Okay, so that was the all theory I give you out. Now let's time to do some practice. But I don't know. I'm already trying, but it's not. Let me try once again. Okay, sorry, I am actually lie to you guys. In description, I will write in the pure C, but for some of part I use Golang, so yeah, sorry. Yes, I admit it, I have skill issue in C. So this is was the my XDP program. I have back end. I create the load balancer, so I have back end like 13, 20, and 10. And load balancer have one IP. The master IP is 15. So, okay, this is working gladly. As you can see, we have three big end. Ubuntu nested 1, 2, and 3. So in eBPF program, I have three backend two, 30, 20, and 10. And the load balancer IP is 15. When I call from my host, it will balancing the traffic from the host I injected eBPF, which is Ubuntu nested 5. Sorry, this one. It's keep load balancing. And the powerful one was, if I TCP dump, if I TCP dump the host who injected the BPF, it will not showing. So the load balancer was happening in an IC itself. It's not entering the Linux networking space. It will make optimization in the load balancer itself. So there's no buffer in the user space or change in the kernel space. If I can do this. But now the mystery is how we can trace the BPF. So in BPF, we can trace because in the BPF program, I already print some output, so we can trace it. Yes, like this one, the backend ID. Backend ID will be printed, or if the unknown backend, and other things. So, when I create the request, the output in here, in the host who injected BPF, will be printed out. This is how we test the BPF itself. But now, actually, because we, let's back to the set one. Let's back to this set. So we have three modes, right? Generic, native, and offload. So let's deep dive to native one. So in native one, it's what working on driver side. Since my host was VM or virtual machine, so the driver is virtual. Let's try the check the driver itself. So interface ENP3S0 is was binded to NAT2 in my laptop. Let's TCP dump it. So, when I create a request, this one TCP dump. When I create the request, in the host ejected BPF was not showing the output. Why? Because the BPF was working on driver side. But when I typing interface, when I typing the interface peer in the VM1, it's printing the output. Yes, this one. And as you can see, the output was first request was from the 1000, and after that forwarded to 15. After that, the 15 was changed the direction to 10, which is the backend ID. So that's all for the XDP1. Is I have to masih ada waktu? Let's continue to the load balancer, but in the CH group one. Okay, we continue. Seems like no problem. So in this BPF program, I create a load balancer, but on this time I will not attach it into the interface. Instead, we modify the IP in the syscall itself. Here, I creating the virtual IP was 100. Let's make it. This one, this was the virtual IP, and this one was the backend one. We have two backend. And I have one container to be my client. So the BPF are already attached with ID and web browser. Okay, I think I have some problem. So, gladly I have the record one. Sorry. Okay, the rule was same. I have virtual IP and the backend one. And first, I was using Turo to the, let's verify if the virtual IP was cannot have a response. But when we call the backend, it's showing the request. After that, I run the BPF program and attach it into the user, into the CA group. And when after I attach the BPF program into the user CA group, the VIP was now have response. So the BPF program already injected in the CA group itself. Now, let's take a look when we do the S3. So at first, at this time, the VIP was still in this S3, was 100 blah blah. And after that, after a second, when the syscall get pair names was called, the VIP was changed. That happened inside the BPF itself. So we modify the request based on the syscall itself. So there's no IP roles with many chains like in the Kubernetes one. It will make some request more optimization or less cost. Sorry, I is installing the packet. Now, I have the Docker or container one as the client. As you can see, the container was cannot reach the VIP because we still not yet injected the BPF code in the CA group itself. So at this time, I was attached the BPF code inside the container itself. This is was the ID of container. As you can see, this was 75, 7, 7530F. So yeah, this is just the idea of container. And after that, I trying again to troll the virtual IP. And it's make the response. So the BPF code was injected in the CH group itself. It was not using any IP tables. What we do modifying the syscall itself. So it was less cost of the using IP tables. And since we can attach in the CH group, so we can create different BPF with different rule and attach it in another container. So I think that's all from me about the BPF. Maybe from you, I have a question. Mas, tolong ada yang nanya.
Cek. I want to ask about the you mentioned at first, because if I'm not wrong, hearing it, calling syscall is more cheaper than using IP tables.
Yes.
I don't know how it how it's like that, because when we are calling syscall, doesn't processing something in the disk, so actually it costs the I/O of the disk.
Yes.
Isn't it like that? Are there some other consideration that it's called more cheaper using calling syscall instead of IP tables? Because there is some trade-off on the storage itself rather than the network. I just need to understand it better. The trade-off between calling the syscall itself rather than doing it on the IP table side. I think that's my question.
Maybe another question, so I can answer it first.
Thank you for your presentation. By yes. Writing code using BPF,
yes.
Does it mean that we use it? We write the code in user space and put hook into kernel space, or we write just another kernel module?
Sorry, can you repeat the last statement?
Programming in C language in Linux, we can create the code in user space, or we can create code running as kernel module, kernel space, kernel area.
Okay.
By using eBPF, does it mean we can create user space code that run as a hook into kernel
space
object or other things?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Maybe I will answer first for the question number one. So the question is, if we modify the syscall, when we modify the syscall, we have process to modify the syscall, right? That's your question, right? Why we solve modify the syscall instead of using IP tables? So in here was the example of my Kube mini cluster. He have a cluster IP. So let's use theory first. So why we should modify the syscall rather than use the IP tables? IP tables was using or use chains for one rule to another rule. So if we have load balancer, so we have five backend, so we have five rule in IP tables, and touch rule was forwarding one by one. What's the cost of forwarding packets one by one? Yes, CPU time and of course memory. Actually, I want to show you about how Kubernetes handling the service, but it's not showing. No, my laptop was not charged, so the CPU was low. I think this is more accepted. Sorry, I forget if I already changed my CNI to Kelenium, so I cannot show to you. Okay. But I have the theory in my blog. You can fix it, or we can talk after this one. I have the evidence on there how the Kubernetes handling how Kubernetes using IP tables and make it more worse. And the second question is, I little forget. But the point is, the BPF code was written in C, and it is running in the user space. After that, hooking the kernel space, right? So, theoretically, when we create the BPF code, it was translated into BPF bytecode machine, because BPF itself was virtual machine inside the kernel level. You can image like the Java virtual machine. So they have own CPU instruction. So when we code the BPF in C and compile it with slang, it will converted into BPF CPU assembly, CPU instructor, sorry. So there's no hook in the BPF between the C code with the kernel. Or you have another question? Or how about anyone? Question? Like, maybe this one was running in BSD or not? Or yeah, that one. Who use BSD? BSD can do this or not? Okay, if there's no question, thank you for the time. Let's, it's breaking it. Okay, thank you.